everyone, today I'm going to share a cute little project with you, and it was inspired by a little bit of luck that I had recently. And the little stamp that you can see in the bottom right hand corner is a stamp called Ignis, and I happened to win it. And the lovely Magda, I'm not quite sure how to say this, but I think it's Polakow, who is a designer for Stampotique. This is one of her stamps, and she had a little giveaway recently, and this is a little tag that came along with my lovely new stamp. So I'm going to hopefully have as much fun as Magda's had here creating this little tag. I love all the texture, and I just wanted to share the fun of inking up a new stamp. So this is by a stamp by Stampotique and the designer Magda Polakow. So I've got a little design in mind, and I'm going to be using this blank wooden frame. It actually came from a shop called B&Q in the UK, which is like a DIY place around Christmas time, so I'm not sure if they carry them all the time, but I'm sure that you can pick up very similar items in your local craft shop, you know, those kinds of blank items ready for you to decorate. I'm just having a little play here on different ways that perhaps you could use this kind of frame. You could have the heart on the top instead of in the place it's meant to be, so you've got a little bit of creativity to bring into play should you want to, but I've got a little idea in mind, so I'm going to keep my heart in the back. So the first thing that I want to do is cover the little frame, and I want to paint it with this broken china distress paint. You could use acrylic paint to do this, but I quite like my distress paints because they come with the applicator on the top and they're really easy to use. So the only thing that I would say if you are using distress paint like this is not to press on any sharp edges to get your paint flowing, because there's a little bit of a valve in the top of the applicator, and I find that if I need to release any more paint, I like to make sure you're doing it on a flat surface and not against a sharp edge, otherwise you start to ruin the top of your little applicator. So I've got a few places here that I can't get to with the actual top of the distress paint, so I'm going to be using a paintbrush in order to do that. So you could quite easily be using acrylic paint, or you could be using distress stains to colour your wooden pieces, but I'm going to be using paint and ink today. So I'm also covering the little heart that's going to be visible once it's back in its little home at the back of the frame, and I'm just making sure that I don't end up with any edges showing once this project is all put together. I'm giving it a second coat because that first coat sank into the bare wood. There's no treatment on this wood, so I'm just taking the paintbrush and going through and covering all those little edges that are going to show once the frame is put back together. So once you've got everything coated, you just need to make sure it's dry, and you can either leave that to dry naturally in the air, or you can speed things up by using your heat gun. And I'm going to add some shading with my distress inks, and I'm going to be using Salty Ocean and Broken China to do this. And I've got my little ink applicators, and I'm going to be shading the top portion with the Salty Ocean and the bottom portion with the Broken China. So I've got a slightly darker top edge to this little project, and a slightly lighter bottom. It's quite subtle, but it just gives a nice little extra bit of dimension. And I'm making sure that I dry my distress inks off after I've finished applying them. I'm adding the broken china to the bottom portion of the frame, and then I'm coming back in again for a second coat with the Salty Ocean. And that just gives a little bit of difference between light and shade on the front of the picture frame. So keep working until you're happy with your depth of colour. And I think that's about it. It's very subtle, as you can see. And then I'm just drying it off with my heat gun. I also inked around the sides of the frame using those two colours. And I'm repeating the technique using the two colours on the heart that's going to go behind the little frame. Now, distress ink always remains reactive to water, so I'm just flicking a few spots of water onto my inked surfaces, and then I'm just going to take a piece of kitchen roll and I'm going to blot off the excess water, and you can see it just adds some subtle lightening to the ink, creates texture on the piece, and I'm just repeating that process until I'm happy with the amount of texture that I've added, and then back in with a heat gun to dry everything off. So you can see where the water has lifted the ink and created this little spotty texture. So to add a little bit more texture, I've got this script stamp from Creative Expressions. I've left it unmounted so I can just get little areas, random areas of text onto my painted pieces. So again, I'm just adding more texture and I'm doing it quite randomly and just tapping the stamp against the little pieces, and you can see there I've added some more texture. And I'm just going to make sure that's dry before I do anything else to the piece. And then I'm going to repeat that process on the frame. But this time I know not much of the actual text is going to show. So I'm just trying to keep the pieces that I add to the edge. And that's the area that will be left uncovered when I finish my design. Now I just want to know how wide my frame is. And I'm going to cut a square of book paper slightly smaller, so I've decided on a 3-inch square, and because my book pages are slightly flimsy, I'm going to back them with a piece of cardstock, so I'm cutting that into a 3-inch square, and then I'm going to choose a piece of book paper. Now I do like to flick through my book and find a page for something like this that's got a word on it that I like for the particular project, and because I've used quite a lot of my book, I'm way down with the V, the letter V, and I picked Venus because she's the goddess of love, and I'm going to be using that page to cut my 3-inch square from my book paper. Then I need to join these two pieces together, and I'm going to use my Ranger multimedia mats for this. And as you can see, I need to order another jar. There's not much left in here, but I've got enough to do what I want for this project. So I'm just taking some of the medium and I'm going to completely cover the square and attach the book paper to it. So once it's completely covered, I'm just adding the book page on top, trying to keep everything smooth and just lining it up exactly with the cardstock square. And I do want that to dry before I go on to the next step, making sure I don't get glue everywhere, so just have a quick clean up. Because I'm going to sew this little square, I need to make sure that that glue's dry so I don't gunk up my machine. Many of you have seen me use this little machine before in another video, and I'm just going to hold the square in position where it's going to be on the frame once I glue it into position, and then I'm taking a pencil. Be careful to try and hold onto that piece so it doesn't move. I'm just changing my grip slightly, and then I'm going to just draw around the inside of the frame with a pencil. And now I've got the area marked out, and I can cut this area away with a craft knife. Then I'm just taking my craft knife and cutting around. I thought I might be able to use my scissors, but can't quite get them in and close enough to that line. So I'm just taking my craft knife and I'm running it around that heart shape. As you can see, I've just cut a cross in the centre of the heart, and it just makes me able to cut out these sections and move them out of the way a little bit at a time. And sometimes it's easier to do this rather than be tempted to try and cut round the whole shape in one go. And then I'm just taking my frame and checking that that's all correct, and I'm happy with that. You can see things starting to take shape. Now I'm going to add some fun stitch details. I'm loading up my little sewing machine with some black thread, just threading the needle, and then I'm going to stitch around my little book page square. And I'm just using my little machine to add a stitched border around my book page. And the only thing that I've got to be careful of using this little machine is that it's actually a chain stitch, so I need to finish off my edges or my stitches at the end of the row just to make sure that they don't unravel. So I'm just being a little bit careful of that as I take the piece out of the machine. Now, if you do this on a big sewing machine, obviously you won't have that same problem, but it is nice to neaten off the edge, and I'll show you what I'm going to do with that. So I'm just releasing that first stitch, and now I'm going to stitch around the heart shape. This is a little bit more tricky, and I'm not really too bothered at that. It's not perfect because it goes with this range of stamps, or my little Ignis stamp in this case, and so I'm not too worried about it, this being a perfect stitch line. In fact, I decide that I'd quite like to emphasize the fact that it's a little bit higgledy-piggledy, and I go around a second time, as you will see in a moment. So if you're using a normal sewing machine, all you need to do is bring your threads to the front of your project piece and tie them off and trim the ends so you've got a little bit of a knot showing. But I need to just catch that little chain stitch in to the project so it doesn't unravel. And then I'm bringing the threads through to the front and tying them in a little knot. So I'm doing that on the border on the outside and then repeating the process. And I've got a little bit of stitching that unraveled that I'm just redoing. It's quite easy to do because the holes are already there. And then I'm just going to bring both threads through to the front and again tying a little knot and trimming the edge of the stitch. I've got a little loop there, and I'm just going to add a little bit of glue to keep that in place. So that's my stitching done, and now I'm just going to distress the edges of the outside and the inside of this little frame. And I'm just doing this lightly by scraping my scissors along the edge of the card. And then I'm just going to take my black soot distress stain, or distress ink, should I say, and I'm just inking the edges. A little bit tricky on the inside of the heart. But that's ready to attach to the little frame. But before I do that, I want to add a little bit more texture again to the painted pieces. So I've got some white distress paint and some black, and I'm going to take quite a stiff paintbrush. This could be a toothbrush actually, and I'm just flicking with my finger to create little splatters all over the frame and the little heart shape. So I'm starting with white. And I did notice that these little drops do sink a little bit into this project because it's not sealed and the wood obviously is still a little bit porous. And then I'm going to use the black. The black was a little bit more successful with its dots and stood out more, so I felt that I needed to balance this up a little bit with a bit more white. So once I dried the little black splatters, I came back in again with some more white and just balanced them up a little bit by creating a few more splatters. Now this is a little bit messy, this technique, so it's also handy to have an old box on standby. Just tip the box on its side so that you can place your piece inside the box, and then you can splatter and spray to your heart's content without it going all over everything that's on your desk or on the wall in front of you. So I'm now going to ink the edges of my little frame and my little heart. So again, I'm using black soot to do this. Black soot distress ink, and I just needed to make sure that I really did ink the edges of this quite deeply, and I kept putting the heart back in the frame to see what actually showed, because I do want you to be able to see that little black edge all the way around. And that's why it looks a little bit heavy-handed, but once it's in the frame it doesn't show as much. And then I decided that little script that I'd put on earlier has really disappeared into the wood. So I'm just going to add a little bit more, again using that Salty Ocean Distress Ink. And then when I glued my frame on, I'm using Cosmic Shimmer glue, which is my favourite. I'm just making sure the glue is around all the stitched areas because they're slightly raised, and then making sure everything is pressed down well. It's worth making sure your fingers are clean at this point because I've got a little bit of black ink on mine now, but it's not going to worry me too much because of the actual nature of the design. I've had a little test run with my stamp and I'm ready to stamp onto this cardstock, and I've tried to match the cream cardstock to the colour or the shade of my book page, and then I'm stamping my little Ignis stamp onto that, and I'm going to cut her out. So I'm using a black archival ink because I intend to colour her a little bit with my distress inks. I'm just probably only need two, but I'm just stamping one for luck just in case I make any mistakes on the cutting out. And then when I've finished examining my inky fingers, I'm going to make sure she's dry before I cut her out so that I don't smudge her. And I decided just to give her a little bit of body on her arms in particular as I'm going to cut them out a second time. I'm just cutting her out with a little bit of border rather than trying to cut round on the actual line of the stamp itself. The other thing that I'm doing is, because of how I want to position her, I'm going to cheat a little bit and give her a little bit more body, and I'm just going to leave that little strip in place until I'm ready to work out how long I want Ignis to be, how far she sits on the edge of my frame. And I'm just running around with my craft knife and taking out little sections so that you can see through her to the frame beyond. And now I'm just going to work out how much extra, or how much little bit of body that I just want to add. So I'm just following the actual design of the stamp, and I'm just adding a couple more. They almost look like ribs. I'm sure they're not. I'm sure that Ignis eats well. And just elongating her body slightly so that she can sit nicely on the edge of my picture frame. And then for my second layer, I'm going to cut poor old Ignis off at the elbow, and I'm just going to keep her little elbows, hands, and the little hugs and kisses sign. Next up, I want some hearts. So sorry about the camera shaking, but this is a very old tool. It was way back in the day when I started paper crafting that I bought these. And actually, they're quite useful because you can cut these holes anywhere on a piece of paper. You're not limited by the edge of a punch. They're good for taking out your frustrations at the end of a long day's crafting. And I'm just cutting out lots of little hearts to use on my project. I ended up using 6 hearts in total, and I've doubled them up, so I've got 3 hearts for my little project. So next up, I'm using a piece of silver wire, and I'm just wrapping it a couple of times around the actual heart shape. Sorry, it's a little bit off camera, but you can see roughly what I'm doing. This one's a little bit better, but I actually only end up using one of these hearts. So I'm just wrapping it around and then trimming it off at the back. So that's the 2 little hearts wrapped. And then I decided I wanted to make a little hanging section. So I folded a piece of wire in half, and then I'm going to create little springs by wrapping it around this barbecue skewer. So I've got 2 little springs at each side of my wire. And then I'm just leaving enough wire to wrap it round 2 hearts. So I'm going to attach 2 hearts to the end of each of these wires. So just deciding when to stop with the spring, and then releasing it from my barbecue skewer. I think I've pulled my wire a little bit tight. That's it, you've done it. So I'm going to use this bit at the top just to wrap it around the actual string of the picture frame, and then I'm using these little long bits to wrap around the hearts. So starting off by adding it to the picture frame, so I'm just looping it around the string and then twisting one wire over the other. And then I'm capturing the heart with the piece of wire that's left and just wrapping that around the front of the heart. And I do add a little bit of hot glue to the back of this to make sure they stay secure, because I probably could have done with leaving a slightly longer piece of wire and that would have held them slightly better. But the bit of hot glue does the trick, and you'll see me doing that in a moment. Things are starting to take shape now, and I'm just starting to think about what I'm going to put where. I've decided that I want to add some wings to the little heart that's sitting in the heart-shaped frame. So I'm just sketching those on a little piece of book paper using a heart shape as a template, just to get the right size and positioning. And then I'm going to just cut those out. I'm using the same method as I did for the Ignis stamp, and I'm just leaving a little border around my sketching. I want to add a little bit of colour to my stamped image. I wasn't quite sure which blue to use to colour in her little hugs and kisses sign, and I thought maybe I could use the Salty Ocean, but I think I like this colour, so I'm going to go with the Broken China, and I'm just colouring in my stamped image using my distress inks, and I'm just squeezing them or pressing the pad against my craft mat to create a puddle of ink, and then I'm just using it like a watercolour, and I'm colouring in Ignis's body and her little hugs and kisses sign on the second piece. And then I just wanted to add a little bit of red into the mix. And I've chosen Festive Berries to do this because it's quite a blue red, which matches the cardstock that I've used for my hearts. And I'm just colouring the frame of her, Ignis's little sign. And then I did think, actually, she's looking a little pale. So I'm going to give her a little rosy glow to her cheeks. And I'm just practicing on this spare piece, which you can't see on camera. But I just wanted to test what she was actually going to look like. I wanted to keep it nice and light, so I'm adding plenty of water to my ink. And then as soon as I've got the colour on, I'm kind of blotting it off with a dry brush so I don't get too much colour, and I'm blending it away into her face. So she looks just like she's a little bit shy. Perhaps she's just blushing slightly. So I want Ignis to be a little bit raised from my project. So I'm just adding foam pads to the back of her and then sticking her in position on the corner of the frame. And then I'm adding foam pads on the sign and a little bit of glue at the elbows so that the elbows join flush to the main image. I'm positioning the wings with some glue, and then I'm using my hot glue, which I forgot to turn on, so I'll be back in a minute. So whilst I'm waiting for my hot glue to heat up, I'm going to add a sentiment, and I've printed out a sentiment onto a piece of cardstock the same colour as that I've stamped my main image on, and it says everybody needs a hug sometimes, and that's my little sentiment, and I think it goes quite well with this lovely stamp. I wasn't sure what font size to use, so I just printed a couple of different sizes, and then I've picked the middle one, and I'm going to use that as the sentiment on my little frame. And as usual, my glue gun always plays up on camera, but I've managed to get some glue onto the back of the heart. And you can see here the reason that I'm adding glue to these hearts on the wire, just to make sure that they don't fall out of the little coil of wire wrapped around them. But I am going to attach this one. I'm adding a little bit of black distress ink to each of the hearts. I wish I'd have thought of doing that sooner. And also to the word strip that I'm going to use. And then I'm going to tuck that heart back inside. And you can see I'm just adding a little tiny dot of glue to make sure that they don't fall out of their wire. And just trying in retrospect to get a little bit of the distress ink onto the heart that's inside the frame. And then I'm just going to cut my words apart and attach them into position on my frame. So I do a little dry run first. Everybody needs a hug sometimes. And then I'm just going to attach these with PVA glue because it's paper on paper and that glue will work nicely. I'm just being a little bit random and I quite like them protruding a little bit into the heart-shaped frame. And then I just want to make sure that this little heart spring stays in place and doesn't go over my words by attaching that on with a little dot of glue to the edge of the frame. Just adding a fine line around each of my words to match the stitching on my frame and just dirtying Ignis up a little bit with some black soot distress ink because she was looking a little bit pristine, and I think that just adds to her character and the look of this little project. So I was just thinking I was finished and I thought that the little hanger was a bit long, so I've just tied a knot and I'm going to just trim into the top of that with my scissors and fray the knot, and I think that that just looks a little bit better than the long string that I had previously. And I think I'm going to call that finished. So I really hope that you've enjoyed this project, and I've certainly enjoyed using my brand new stamp. So thanks to Magda for the lovely giveaway, and I've really enjoyed playing with my brand new stamp. I hope that you've enjoyed this little tutorial and that it gives you lots of ideas for small projects of your own. It didn't take me that long to do, but I've really enjoyed it and I hope that you like how it's turned out. Don't forget, if you like my videos, to hit subscribe and feel free to share them with your friends. And I look forward to getting creative with you soon. And until next time, thank you for watching.